Hello and welcome to this Excel tip. In this Excel tip, we're going to talk about the Select Data tool, which is one of the best tools to make different types of charts and to tell Excel exactly how you want to make those charts. So in past videos, we would select the two columns that we wanted to make a chart of, and we'd go ahead and insert and make that chart. Sometimes, though, when you're dealing with more complicated data sets, where the data is not right next to each other or other issues, this may not work well. So what I want to show you is if we start from scratch and have Excel do, you tell Excel exactly what you want to plot. So let's start just in a blank cell, and now we're going to insert a chart. And since we have no data, the chart's going to be completely empty. So, it selected that data for some reason. So let me get rid of that for now. So let's go over to here and go to insert. Okay, so now we have a blank chart. So no data, nothing. So what we're gonna do now is tell Excel exactly we right click and we go to the Select Data tool. This is a really, really important tool, and you're gonna use it all the time when making charts. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is these are the different series of data. So if we wanted to plot population and crime rate and median household income, we would add each of these to make it. Right now, let's start off easy. Let's start off just with population. Let's go ahead and add this data set. So the series name is population. So we can click that. So it's just the name. That's just the name of the series. So that'll show up in the legend and whatnot. It's not any of the data. The series values, this is where the data is. So we want to get rid of that, and we want to select the data that we want to use. And you can see what's nice about Excel is that it starts populating the chart right away. And let's go ahead and hit OK. Now, this isn't great because it doesn't have Wilmington, Philadelphia, it doesn't have those labels on the bottom. So here is where those axis labels come into play. So let's go ahead and click Edit to select those axis labels. So we're going to do the axis labels, and that's where the axis labels are going to be. And again, what's really nice is it auto-populates for you in the background to make sure you're doing what's good. Okay, great. And then let's go ahead and hit OK. So right now, we built this chart with a Select Data dialog. This is a foolproof way to tell Excel exactly what you want to do. Now, let's go ahead and build another chart. So I'm going to drag this down here with the Select Data dialog. And I'm going to insert now a scatter chart. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go to Select Data and we're going to add a legend series. Now, it's a little bit different because it's a scatter chart. It has both X values and Y values. So the series name here, we're going to do crime rate for our X values versus median household income. And for the X values, we're going to do the crime rate. And the Y values, we're going to do the median household income. And you can see it populates here. And let's go ahead and hit OK. So it auto-populates for us. Now, the interesting part about this is that the horizontal category axis labels, we can't edit because they come from the X values over here. So if I wanted to, go ahead and look at what I did, instead of clicking Add, I could just click Edit, and I could change any of these things here. So actually, let's do one more. Let's go ahead and bring back up our population graph. And let's go ahead and right-click Select Data. And let's go ahead and add, now we have population, let's add the crime rate on here. So we're going to do the series name is the crime rate, and the series value is those data values. And you can see it doesn't really come up because the crime rate's so low compared to the population. So what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and hit OK. We're going to change this chart type to so that the crime rate is on the secondary axis. Now we've done this before, but this time we did it with the select data dialog. And let's go ahead and see what the select data dialog looks like now. Turns out it's exactly the same. It's just what it puts on the two secondary axes here. Okay, that's it for the select data dialog tool. It's one of the most powerful tools in Excel, so make sure you mess around with it and see how to use it. And thanks for watching.